Hello friends, welcome to this video on quadrilaterals. In the previous video, we discussed about some properties of a parallelogram. Today, we will solve some questions based on that. Let's move ahead. In the given figure, quadrilateral DEFG is a parallelogram. Show that triangle DOE and triangle FOG are congruent. Triangle DGE and triangle FGE are also congruent. Friends, according to the question, DEFG is a parallelogram. Therefore, sides DE and GF will be parallel. If we consider DF a diagonal, then angle EDF and angle GFD will be alternate angles. And we know that alternate angles are equal. And we can say that in triangles DOE and FOG, angles EDO and angle GFO are equal. Angle DOE and angle FOG will be equal because both these angles are vertically opposite angles. We know that the opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Therefore, sides DE and FG will be equal. Now look at equations 1, 2 and 3. In both these triangles, two angles and one side is equal. But this side is not the included side of these angles. So this triangle is congruent according to the AAS congruence rule. Friends, now look at triangle DGE and triangle FEG, both of which are derived by dividing the parallelogram DEFG by diagonal GE. We know that a diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Therefore, these two triangles will be congruent. Friends, similarly discuss triangle DGF and triangle FED with your classmates. Let's move to our next question. PQRS is a parallelogram with side SR of length 4 cm and side QR of length 3 cm. Then, find the lengths of sides PQ and PS. Friends, we know that the opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. We are given that the quadrilateral PQRS is a parallelogram, so its opposite sides will be equal. That means side PQ is equal to side SR and the length of side SR is given as 4 cm. Therefore, the length of side PQ will also be 4 cm. Similarly, sides QR and PS will also be equal. Here we are given the length of side QR to be 3 cm. So, the length of side PS will also be 3 cm. Let's move ahead and look at another question. Quadrilateral PQRS is a parallelogram and quadrilateral PXYZ is also a parallelogram. The measure of angle R is given to be 60 degrees. Then, find the measure of angle P and angle Y. According to the question, PQRS is a parallelogram and we know that the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. Therefore, angle P and angle R will be equal. The measure of angle R is given to be 60 degrees. So, angle P will also be equal to 60 degrees. And according to the question, PXYZ is also a parallelogram. With its help, find the measure of angle Y yourself. Friends, that's all in this session. Today, we solved some questions related to some properties of a parallelogram. See you in the next video with some more similar questions. Thank you.